Good morning to all the children. Yes, Pita, class 9th D. By the time you were joining, I have again mentioned the characters here. Already introduced to you. There is king and his minister. Then we have guru and his disciple. Disciple means follower of that guru. Fine, almost all of you were present. So I need not repeat the characters again. But yes, I told you one more thing. I told you about the theme of the chapter. So who will tell me what was the theme? I will unmute you and you will tell me, then I will write. Raise your hand. Pratiksha has raised hand as usual. What about others, Beta? I told you the theme of the chapter yesterday only. I had written on board also. Yes, who knows? I will be writing on board after asking you. So yes. Yes, Riyanshika has written, but I have asked you to unmute. Yes, Titiksha, speak. Riyanshika ne one theme de di hai. Yes.
Ma'am, in the company we stay, we become like that.
Okay. We are known by the company we keep. We are known by the company we keep, or we become like the person if we stay in the company of a fool. Yes. Now, no. Anybody else can speak? Arush, my question is.
Ma'am, may I mute myself?
Beta, you can mute yourself. Your turn is done now. Fine. So, Arush, you have asked me, the question is, I told you the theme yesterday. You tell me what was the theme. First is just discussed with Taniksha. We are known by the company we keep, or we become the kind of company we keep. Yes, I would like to ask. Let me see in the chat box. Yes, Riyanshika has written the same. We are known by the company we keep. Any other theme of this chapter? Do not follow others blindly. Do not follow others blindly. Have your own, use your own brain. Apply your wit. Fine, apply your brain. This is another theme. Don't follow others blindly. We are known by the company we keep. Fine. And there are n number of themes you can extract. There are some things we should not change. Yes, we should follow some norms. We should follow discipline in life. Fine. We should not get attracted to the offers, or you can say stupid offers made by others. The way they got stuck in this. Fine. So we will be continuing with the chapter, Beta. I'm going to share the screen now with you all. If you have books, kindly open it. And if you are coming to school, kindly bring moments only. We have one more chapter to do. Yes, Gia has given very good theme to us. We should stay away from these kind of people. Very good, Gia. So let's continue. Yes, Beta. In the kingdom of fools, we have read . So we were on page number 22. Fine. When we all know that the disciple of the guru started living over there, and he kept on eating and he became so fat. And one day what happened, a thief entered into a merchant's house, and while after coming, after stealing the things, when he was coming back, a wall fell upon his head and he died on the spot. So now brother of that thief, he went to king. The king is already, the leader is already a foolish person. So king announced, yes, guilty will be punished. So he calls the owner of the house to give him punishment. So owner of the house, the merchant was brought. He says, my majesty, that I have not built that wall. mason or the, you can say bricklayer, he is responsible. So that bricklayer, that workman was called, he was an old man. He came, he said, not because of my fault, because I was, when I was building the wall, a dancer was walking outside, and due to the tinkling of the sound of her anklets, it distracted me. So then he said, okay, that woman should be called. Now that woman has grown older. So that old woman was called, and everybody was now started putting blames on others. Why? Because they know that the king is foolish and everybody has become like that only. They kept on just putting blames on one another. So page number 22. When dancing girl started giving answer, yes, from this line onwards, let me highlight this. Okay, we are going to read this paragraph. She said, she thought for a minute and said, my lord, wait, I know why I was walking up and down that street. Still students are joining, see. Now, dancing girl, that old woman now, she said that, I tell you why I was walking up and down. I had given some gold to the goldsmith to make some jewelry for me. He was a lazy scoundrel. He made so many excuses, said he would give it to me now and he would give it then, and so now all day. He made me walk up and down to his house a dozen times. So dancing girl puts the blame on the goldsmith, that this jeweler, he was not giving my jewelry back. I kept on roaming here and there. That's why I was visiting that street. So now that goldsmith would be called. He made me walk up and down. So that was when his bricklayer saw me. And it's not my fault, my lord. It's the damned goldsmith's fault. So she puts the blame on goldsmith. Poor thing. She's absolutely right, thought the king. Weighing the evidence. We have got the real culprit at last. Get the goldsmith wherever he's hiding at once. So he gives the order. Who gives the order? The king gives the order to call the goldsmith now. So the king's bailiffs, the meaning of bailiffs, they have given the attendants, a law officer who makes sure that the decisions of a court are obeyed. Bailiff is a person, lawmaker you can say, or follower of law, who will be helping the king. King's bailiff searched for goldsmith, who was hiding in a corner of his shop. When he heard the accusation against him, he had his own story to tell. So he, another story he was forming. My lord, he said, I'm a poor goldsmith. It's true. I made this dancer come many times to my door. I gave her excuses because I could not finish making her jewelry before I finished the rich merchant's orders. He says, why I could not fulfill the order of this dancing girl? Because I was busy in making one more order of that rich merchant. They had a wedding coming, so they would not wait. You know how impatient rich men are. So I was having one order from rich men. And who that rich man was? The same merchant who was called, in whose house that, you can say, thief died. Fine? So same merchant. So the whole circle of blame game started from rich merchant. And again, that blame came to rich merchant only. Fine? Rich merchant gave blame to... Who will tell me now? Now my question is, let me check. I'm just saying the blame game. You will be naming in order that who puts blame on whom. Fine, Titiksha cannot answer this question because she always raises her hand. Any other child, that firstly, the blame was on rich merchant in whose house the thief died. The wall was crumbly. So Arush is the second one to raise hand. Okay, Arush, you can speak in the right order.
Ma'am, the merchant blame the one who made the wall brick.
Bricklayer, yes. Then?
Bricklayer.
Or the mason.
And then the bricklayer blamed the dancer, and the dancer blamed the goldsmith.
And goldsmith blamed rich merchant again. This is the order. Okay, very good. You try it. You can mute yourself. Okay, beta. So this was the order. Now, the king's bailiffs, they got this answer also. So who is the rich merchant who kept you from finishing this poor man's woman's jewelry, made her walk up and down, which distracted this bricklayer, which made a mess of his wall, which has now fallen on an innocent man and killed him? Can you name him? See the order. So he's saying this, that you name that, who's that rich merchant? The goldsmith named the merchant, and he was none other than the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen. Now justice had come full circle, thought the king. King was saying, this is the right decision. Do you think this is the right decision? Write me in the chat box. Do you think this is the right decision? No. So Rishabh is saying no. Rest of you, yes. It is not a right decision, because this is not the way to, you know, find the culprit. So goldsmith named the merchant, and he was the original owner, and he's now going to be punished by the king. When he was rudely summoned means called, back to the court, he arrived crying, "It wasn't me, but my father who ordered the jewelry. He's dead. I'm innocent." He kept on giving these arguments that I was not the one who gave order for jewelry. It was my father. He's no more. But the king consulted his minister and ruled decisively. Decisively making decision. He says, "It is true, your father is the true murderer. He is dead. But somebody must be punished in his place. You have inherited everything from that criminal father of yours, his riches as well as his sins. I knew at once, even when I first set eyes on you, that you were at the root of this horrible crime. So you must die." Just for the sake of taking decision, a king is taking decision. This is not the right way. Fine, he just found the culprit. He's not at all fault. Even then, he's being persecuted. He's being killed or murdered by the orders were given by king that he should be hanged till death. And he ordered a new stake to be made ready for the execution. What is a stake? Beta, you might have seen many scenes of phansi ki saza and all. Fine, so a stake is built. A noose, jo phansi hoti hai, a noose is built, and then a head is, you know, put inside that noose. They tighten up the rope, and then they remove the, you can say, the stage below that person who's to be persecuted. So this is the way they persecute a person, execution. So he gave order that a new stake to be made ready for the execution, and servants sharpened the stake and got it ready for the final impaling of the criminal. It occurred to the minister that the rich merchant was somehow too thin to be properly executed on the stake. When stake was ready, where he is to be persecuted, then minister of the king, he is also a foolish person. So minister thought that he is too thin. He cannot fit the noose at that place. We need a, you can say, chubby person, a fat person. He appealed to the king's common sense. King too worried about it. King said, okay, you are right. He is too thin. What shall we do now? He said, when suddenly it struck him that all they needed to do was to find a man fat enough to fit the stake. See, heights of foolishness. Heights of foolishness. The way they are taking decision that whosoever will be fitting the noose, whosoever will be fat enough to stand at the stake, he will be killed. And their eyes fell on the disciple. Remember now Guru's advice. Guru asked him, you never know if these people are calling day into night and night into day, they can do anything. They are the foolish people. Don't stay here. But disciple did not listen to his guru. He kept on staying in the same place. He kept on eating and feeding himself with bananas and rice and ghee, and he became very fat like a bull. And now he was the only fat person who could fit that stake. So he was taken there, and because he kept on feeding himself with this fat food, what have I done wrong? Yes, let me scroll. What have I done wrong? I'm innocent. I'm a sannyasi, he cried. You know, what is the meaning of sannyasi? A saint. A sannyasi is a person who has left the worldly things. They do not eat much. They eat that much is required for living. But he's not a sannyasi. He's calling himself a sannyasi because he was follower of his guru. But he's not done any karma for sannyasi. He cried, I'm a sannyasi, leave me. That may be true, but it's the royal decree. Royal decree means this is a royal order by the king. Royal, or you can say mannerism, that we should find a man fat enough to fit the stake, they said, and carried him to the place of execution. He remembered his wise guru's words now. Underline, beta, this is very important question. Guru's advice. What was the guru's advice? This is a city of fools. You don't know what they will do next. Fine. This was the advice given by the guru. While he was waiting for death, he prayed to his guru in his heart, asking him to hear his cry wherever he was. He started praying to his guru that, oh my Lord, I did not listen to you. I'm missing you now. Please listen to me. The guru saw everything in a vision. He was a very powerful guru. Gurus, actual people used to have visions in the previous days. If you see, people were so pious. They were so religious minded, clean hearted, and definitely the people with such visions can have clarity of visions. So he had vision that my disciple is in pain. He needs me. The guru saw this. He had magic powers. He could see far and he could see the future as he could see the present and he could see the past. He arrived at once to save his disciple who had got himself into such a scrape through love of food. So such a scrape, it is such a foolish thing to do. As soon as he arrived, he scolded the disciple. The guru folded him, chided him and told him something in a whisper. Uske kaan mein kuch kehte hain, whispering sound. Then he went to the king and addressed him. After saying something into the ear of his disciple, he goes to the king. Who goes to the king? The guru. O wisest of kings, who is greater, the guru or the disciple? Of course, the guru, no doubt about it. Why do you ask? So king answered, yes, guru is the greater. Then put me to the stake first, put my disciple to death after me. So guru said this to king and king was shocked ki why this person wants to die. He's saying, pehle mere ko dalo fansi pe. I want to be at the stake first, then put my follower. Minister and king both are shocked, both got startled that why this guru is saving the life of disciple first and he's saying put me on the stake first. When the disciple heard this, he understood and began to clamor. Me first, you brought me here first, put me to death first, not him. Disciple started saying, no, I want to die first, put me on the stake first. The guru and the disciple now got into a fight about who should go first. Guru and disciple started fighting. I will die first, I will die first. I will go at the stake first, I will go at the stake. The king was so puzzled by this behavior, he asked the guru, why do you want to die? We chose him because we needed a fat man for the stake. You shouldn't ask me such questions. Put me to death first, replied the guru. Guru says, don't ask me, but just put me on the death. Why? There is some mystery here. As a wise man, you must make me understand. So king was now having doubt. He says, what is the reason? There is something. Will you promise me to put me to death if I tell you? So guru is very smart, you know, he's playing a game here. He's saying, okay, promise me you will put me to death. He said, okay. King gave his solemn word. Okay, guru took him aside, side pe leke jata and says, out of the servants, earshot, and whispered to him, do you know why we want to die right now? The two of us, we have been all over the world, but we have never found a city like this or a king like you. That stake is the stake of the God of justice. It's new. It has never had a criminal on it. Whoever dies on it first will be reborn as the king of this country. And whoever goes next will be the future minister of this country. We are sick of our ascetic life. It would be nice to enjoy ourselves as a king and minister for a while. Now keep your word, my lord, and put me to death, my first remember. Got it? Got it? What is the idea behind this? The idea is, guru is always a guru. Disciple can never approach his guru. Guru was very, you know, clever. He made this plan and, you know, he whispered something in the ear of his disciple. What did he whisper? He whispered that I will be asking that let me go on the stage first and you will be yelling. No, I want to go first. I want. And king, you know, people are like that only. These days we become befooled easily by others. We start thinking, okay, something will be there. Fine. So he thought that if he wants to die, guru and disciple both, why? So guru says, whosoever will be dying first, he will become the king in the next birth. And whosoever will be dying second will be becoming the minister in the rebirth. Agle janam. So let me die and let my disciple die after that. That was a plan actually. Fine. So now what will happen? Let's see. We all know, very smart kids these days, you are. The king was now thrown into deep thought. He did not want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. But the next round of life, I want to be the king only. This life maybe I'll be king. Next life maybe I will be the king. He needed time. He kept on thinking. He ordered the execution postponed to the next day. But the next day, execution hoega. Stop it. He talked to his minister. Minister is also a foolish man. It's not right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next life. Let's go on stake ourselves and we will be reborn as king and minister again. Holy men do not tell lies. Holy men do not tell lies means holy. Who is holy man here? The guru. He says he's very religious. Wo jhoot nahi bolega. Kisi ki jaan bachane ke liye jhoot bola jaye to wo jhoot nahi hai. So he told the executioners, we'll send the criminals tonight. Raja and minister, king and his minister, what they decided, okay, we will be dying at the stake. We self will go. He told the executioners that we will send the criminals tonight. First man comes to you, put him to death first. Then do the same to the second man. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. That night, the king and his minister went secretly to the prison. Released the guru and the disciple. Chupke gaye, you know. किसी को पता ना चले डिस्गाइज देमसेल्फ एज द टू एंड एज अरेंज्ड बिफोरहैंड विद लॉयल सर्वेंट्स वर टेकन टू द स्टेक एंड प्रॉम्प्टली एग्जीक्यूटेड इमीडिएटली एग्जीक्यूटेड सी दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन वी फॉलो द कंपनी ऑफ फुलिश पीपल दैट्स व्हाई वी आर नोन बाय द कंपनी वी कीप और वी बिकम लाइक द पर्सन इफ वी स्टे विद सच पीपल. Don't follow others blindly. Apply your brain. Yes, Titiksha, you have a doubt, beta?
Ma'am, I want to ask, how did the blame come to the disciple?
Okay. Blame does not come to the disciple straight away. Firstly, you know that circle when everybody started putting on the blame game started. But when they made that stake, you know, where the person is executed, that place is situated, you know, noose is noose, fancy and stake and everything was there. But the person who will be, you know, strong enough, fat enough to be there, only that person fitted that stake. So when they thought, actually blame was there on rich merchant, but rich merchant was very thin. So they thought, let's find a fat man who fits that noose, who fits that stake. So only person fat enough was that disciple because he kept on eating all the time, you know, because everything was so cheap at that place. You remember in the beginning when Guru said, don't live here. This is the kingdom of fools, and you will become a fool himself. And he became a fool only. With the help of Guru, he was able to came out. Fine? So is it clear to you, Pratiksha? Let's continue the last one. The king was now thrown into deep thought. This is the last. When the bodies were taken down, you can see. When the bodies were taken down, so king and his minister, they died next morning. When bodies were taken out to thrown to crows and vultures, the people panicked, you know, that vulture is a bird, fine, so that birds can eat that body. They saw before them the dead bodies of king and minister. People were amazed. People were shocked. The city was in confusion. What happened? King and minister died last night, in spite of that guru and disciple who wanted to die. All night they mourned. They kept on crying. They discussed the future of the kingdom. Some people suddenly thought of the guru and disciple and caught up with them as they were preparing to leave town unnoticed. So guru and his disciple, they were leaving the place unnoticed. We people need a king and a minister, said someone. Others agreed. They begged the guru and the disciple to be their king and their minister. It didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple. But it took longer to persuade the guru. You remember, guru was not easily persuaded. Manani sakte the aap usko easily. But disciple was easily persuaded. He said, okay, I will be the minister and my guru can be the king. But guru finally agreed to rule the kingdom of the foolish king and silly minister on the condition they could change all the old laws. So guru said, okay, I will be the king if you allow me to change all the laws. So what were the laws prevailing there? Night will be day will be night. From then on, night would again be night and day would again be day. And you could get nothing for a dadu. It became like any other place. So whatever the value of a thing is, that will be paid by you, not a single amount for everything, so that everyone can become greedy like my disciple. So guru became the king, disciple became the minister, they revised the norms and everything became normal. So it is actually beta a Kannada folk tale from A.K. Ramanujan's Folk Tales from India. You can search on Google. Fine, it is a folk tale of Kannada language. It is converted into English. So beautifully written. We have completed in the Kingdom of Fools. So your homework is go through and prepare with the question answers. In next lecture, I will be asking you all. Tomorrow you don't have period of English, I guess. Fine. So bell has gone. I'm ending the meeting. Have a nice day.